गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल बिगिन अ न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 3.3, द लास्ट लीफ। चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर वी बिगिन द लेसन, लेट्स डिस्कस द वार्मिंग अप क्वेश्चंस फर्स्ट व्हिच आर रिलेटेड टू द लेसन। सो द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज, सपोज यू सफर फ्रॉम अ लॉन्ग टर्म इलनेस 1 or 2 weeks, वॉट शुड यू डू एंड वॉट शुड यू अवॉइड? Fill up the table of do's and don'ts. So here is a table, children. Do's and don'ts. Under the column of do's, the first point is given, go to a doctor for diagnosis. In the second column of don'ts, the first point is, do not try any medication on your own. Second point, take medicines on time. Do not avoid medications on time. Third point is, take a suitable diet. Avoid junk food. Next, fourth point is, take rest. Avoid physical stress and exertion. Next, fifth point is, rest in a properly ventilated room. Under the column of don'ts, do not close doors and windows. Sixth point is, have cheerful thoughts, courage and positive attitude. Do not lose hope and courage. Next, question number 2 is, you already know that homophones are pairs of words that sound the same but differ in spellings and meanings. For example, S-U-M, sum, and S-O-M-E, sum. There are some words that even have the same spelling and pronunciations, but have different meanings in different situations or contexts. For example, bat, B-A-T, bat, meaning a bird. The other meaning of B-A-T, bat, we can say sports or games equipment. Next, such words are called homographs. Make pairs of sentences of your own to point out the different meanings of the following homographs. The first word is given, fine. And the sentence is, we decided to go for a picnic only if the day is fine. Next sentence is, students had to pay fine for late fees. The next word is wave. And the sentence is, the flag waved in the gentle breeze. Next sentence is, we saw huge waves coming out of the ocean. The next word is beer. It is said that the beer liked to eat honey. Next sentence is, the pain given by our dear ones is difficult to bear. Next word, fourth, is rose, R-O-S-E, rose. And the sentence is, the rose is a beautiful flower. Next sentence, her anger rose with her voice. Next, fifth word is lead, L-E-A-D, lead. The lead is a heavy metal. Next sentence, I asked my friend, where does this street lead to? Next, sixth word is match. Nowadays, everyone is crazy for watching an IPL match. Next sentence is, his shirt and pant matched perfectly. Next, word number 7th is second. And the sentence is, everything in the surrounding was destroyed in a second after the bomb exploded. Next sentence is, I stood second in drawing competition. Next, the last word is object. Can you describe the object? Next sentence is, he objected to travel by train. So now, children, we'll stop here and we'll continue the lesson in the next video. Thank you. Let's come back to the lesson, children. Lesson number 3.3, the last leaf. Children, before we begin the lesson, let me tell you the summary of the story, The Last Leaf, in short. In the poorer parts of New York, there was a colony where many struggling artists lived. There were two such artists named Sue and Johnsy. They came from different parts of the United States. They became friends and took a flat. They also set up a joint studio to earn a living. Jonsi was small, thin, and not very strong. After a few months, she became ill with pneumonia. Jonsi took all possible care of her, but it seemed that she made up her mind that she was not going to get well. The doctor suggested that she should change her attitude towards life. There was a window. Jonsi could see an ivy vine from it. The leaves of the ivy vine started falling faster. It developed a negative feeling in her mind. She thought, as soon as the tree is bare of all leaves, soon she would die. Once she shared this view with Sue, she suggested her to stop thinking like that and drink broth and have positive attitude. There was an old man named Berman. He too was an artist, but was a failure in his life. He served as a model for the young artist in the colony. He told that he wished to make a masterpiece, but has never done so. She told Berman about the strange feeling Jonsi had. Mr. Berman felt it inappropriate about Jonsi's feeling. That night, there was a heavy cold rain mixed with snow, and fierce wind also blew. Sue and Jonsi could bear it at night. The next morning, Jonsi was staring at the closed window. She ordered Sue to open it because she wanted to see the last ivy leaf. When she opened the window, Jonsi was surprised to see the ivy leaf still hanging bravely from a branch. Though it was still dark green near its stem, but with its edges tinted with yellow, she had expected that the last ivy leaf might not able to bear the harsh extremities of the weather the previous night. She thought it would fall the next day, and so she became even more nervous. The next day, again when they opened the window, the leaf was still there on the branch. It had even faced the previous night extreme weather condition. This developed a positive change in her mind, and she cursed her for having such negative thought. She readily drank the broth and milk. They heard that Mr. Berman was suffering from pneumonia. A sweeper had found him lying helpless in his room with a palette with green and yellow colored mixed. 2 days later, he died. Actually, the ivy leaf had fallen the very first night when there was a stormy weather. Mr. Berman had noticed it, so he drew a similar leaf so that Jonsi would give up her negative feelings. It was his masterpiece that saved Jonsi's life. So now, children, we'll see the lesson paragraph wise. In the poorer parts of New York, there was a colony where many struggling artists lived. Among them were Sue and Jonsi. They had come to New York from different parts of the United States. Children, here, in the poorer parts of New York, in the area where the poor people were living of New York, there was a colony where many struggling artists lived. Struggling means artists working hard for earning their livelihood. Among them were Sue and Jonsi, among the poor family. They had come to New York from different parts, or you can say from different areas of the United States. So now, children, we'll stop here and we'll take a break of 1 minute. Thank you. Let's come back to the lesson. Lesson number 3.3, the last leaf. Children, we were on first paragraph, third line. When they met, they found that they shared the same interest. Who met? Sue and Jonsi. When they meet, they found that they shared the same interest. Their likes and dislikes were the same, and they became friends. So they became friends. They shared a flat and set up a joint studio. They were living in one flat and set up a joint studio, trying to earn a living through art, trying to earn their livelihood through art. Jonsi was small, thin, and not very strong. Jhansi was small, thin, and very weak, not very strong. After spending a few months in New York, she became ill with pneumonia. She fell sick, suffering with pneumonia. In those days, it was not easy to cure pneumonia patients. Those days, it was very difficult to cure pneumonia patients. Though Sue looked after her well, though Sue was taking care of her very well, Jhansi showed no signs of improvement. One day, the doctor told Sue that Jhansi had one chance in 10. One day, the doctor declared that Jhansi had one chance in 10. Very few means very few chance of survival. And that chance is for her want to live, her desire, her wish to live, he said. Who said? Doctor said. Your friend has made up her mind, has decided that she is not going to get well, that she is not going to cure or she is not going to recover. He told Sue that medicines alone did not help if patient did not wish to live. He told Sue that medicines alone are not going to help her if the patient did not wish or want to live. That day, Jhansi just lay in bed without making any sound or movement. So one day, Jhansi was simply lying in the bed without making any sound or movement. First, Sue thought that she had fallen asleep. She is sleeping. But then she noticed that Jhansi was looking out of the window. What she noticed? That Jhansi was looking out of the window, staring out of the window, and was counting something again and again in a very low voice, almost a whisper, almost a very soft volume, soft voice. She was counting something again and again. Sue too looked out of the window, but there was nothing to see. So Sue also looked outside the window, and what she noticed there? Nothing. Only an old ivy vine. Children, here old ivy vine means a strong creeper with green leaves and yellow berries. Gnarled and decayed. Gnarled, twisted, rough, and decayed, damaged at the roots. Climbed halfway up the brick wall. So that ivy vine creeper was climbing halfway up the brick wall. The cold breath of autumn had taken away most of the leaves. The cold breeze of the autumn season had taken away most of the leaves. Only the skeleton branches were left. Only skeleton branches means branches with no leaves were left. Clinging to the bricks. Clinging means children holding or taking the support of the brick to climb. What is it, dear? Asked Sue. Sue asked Jhansi, what is it, dear? Jhansi replied, six. What she said? Six. They are falling faster now. She said, they are falling faster now. Now they are falling very fast. 3 days back, there were almost 100. What she told? There were almost 100. 3 days back. It made my headache to count them. But now it's easy. There goes another one. See, there goes another one. There, one more fall down. There are only 5 left now. So what she was counting? She was counting the leaves on the ivy vine creeper. So previously it made her headache to count them. But now it's easy. Now one more fall down, she told to Sue. There are only 5 left now. So she was counting the leaves. So now children, we will stop here. And we'll proceed further in the next video. Thank you. Let's continue the lesson. Lesson number 3.3, the last leaf. Children, in the previous video, we have read that how Jhansi was counting the leaves of the ivy vine. So let's read further. 5. What, dear? Who asked? Sue asked to Jhansi. 5. What, dear? Leaves on the ivy vine. Who replied? Jhansi replied. Leaves on the ivy vine. When the last one falls, I must go to. When the last leaf will fall, even I will die. I must go to. Even I have to go from this world. I have known that for last 3 days. And I was knowing this from the last 3 days. Didn't the doctor tell you? Didn't the doctor told you? Oh, I never heard of such nonsense. Then Sue replied, oh, I never heard of such foolishness, said Sue. What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? What have this old ivy leaves to do with your recovery or with your getting well? And you used to love that wine, and you used to love that wine, so don't be silly. So don't act foolish. The doctor said that you had excellent chances of getting well. The doctor told that you had good chances of getting well. Take some broth now. Children, broth means hot soup. So have some broth now and let me get back to my work and let me complete my work. But Jhansi just kept looking out of the window. But Jhansi was still staring out of the window. There goes another. And then she said, there falls another. No, I don't want any broth. No, I don't want to have any broth. That leaves just four. Now that leaves are just left four. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. And I want to see the last leaf falling down before it gets dark. Then I'll go too. Then even I'll die. Then even I'll go from this world. Jhansi, said Sue, will you promise me to keep your eyes closed and not look out of the window until I am done working? Jhansi, said Sue. Sue asked Jhansi that will you promise me to keep your eyes closed and not look out of the window until I am completing all my household work? I must hand those drawings in tomorrow. I have to hand over those drawings in tomorrow. I need the light, so I required the light. Otherwise, I would have closed the window. Otherwise, I could have closed the window. I don't want you to keep looking at those silly ivy leaves. And I don't want that you to keep staring at those silly ivy leaves. Tell me as soon as you have finished. Tell me as soon as you have completed your work, said Jhansi, closing her eyes. Because I want to see the last one fall. Because I want to see the last leaf falling down. Try to sleep, said Sue. Try to sleep, asked Sue to Jhansi. I must call Burman up to be my model for the old man that I am drawing. I have to call Burman to be my model for the old man I am drawing now. I'll not be gone a minute. I'll be back within a minute. Old Burman was a painter who lived on the ground floor. So old Burman was a painter who used to live on the ground floor. But he was a failure in his career. For 40 years he had wielded the brush. For 40 years he had painted with a view to flourish, but had not made any money. He had been always about to paint a masterpiece. He was always trying to paint a masterpiece, but had never started it. For several years, he had only made a few paintings. For several years, he had only made a few paintings. He earned a little by serving as a model to the young artists in the colony. He used to earn a little only by serving as a model to the young artists in the colony, who could not afford other models. He always talked of his coming masterpiece, and he always used to talk about his coming masterpiece. Who? Old Burman, the painter Old Burman. So now, children, we will stop here and we'll proceed further in the next video. Thank you. Good morning, children. Today we will continue lesson number 3.3, The Last Leaf. Children, in the previous video, we have read that how Old Burman always talked about his coming masterpiece. Children, here masterpiece means a most valuable or outstanding work of an artist. Now, let's read further. Sue told Berman about Jonsi's fancy. Children, fancy means imagination. Sue told Berman about Jonsi's fancy. Old Berman was shocked that anyone could have such idiotic imaginings. Old Berman was shocked. He was surprised that anyone could have such foolish imaginings. What, he cried, are there people in the world foolish enough to die because of leaves dropping off from a vine? Are there people in the world foolish enough to die just because of leaves dropping off from a vine? I have not heard of such a thing. I have never heard such kind of thing. Why did you allow this thought to enter her brain? And why did you allow this kind of thought to enter into her brain? She is very ill and weak, said Sue. The fever has made her mind full of fancies. She is sick, very weak, said Sue. And the fever has made her mind full of fancies, full of imaginations. The place is not good for Miss Jonsi. Someday I'll paint a masterpiece and we shall all go away. This place is not good or not proper for Miss Jonsi. Someday I'll paint a masterpiece and we shall all go away and we shall all die or we shall all go away from this world. Yes, said Berman. Jonsi was sleeping when the two went upstairs. Sue showed Berman the ivy vine that Jonsi saw through the window. Sue showed Berman the ivy vine that Jonsi always used to see through the window. They looked at each other for a moment, without speaking, without uttering a word, and then began their work. Outside, a cold rain was falling continuously. Outside, a cold rain was falling continuously, mixed with snow. So, a cold rain mixed with snow was falling outside continuously, full night. Sue closed the window. Next morning, when Sue woke up, she found that Jonsi was staring at the closed window again with dull, wide open eyes. So next morning when Sue woke up, she found that Jonsi was still looking at the closed window again with dull, wide open eyes. Open the window. I want to see, she ordered. Who ordered? Jonsi ordered. Open the window. I want to see out, she ordered. Sue obeyed. Sue opened the window. But what happened? But lo. Lo is here the expression of surprise or shocked. Even after the rain and the fierce wind that blew throughout the night. Children, here blew is the past tense of blow. Blew throughout the night. The fierce wind that blew throughout the night, there yet stood against the brick wall one ivy leaf. There yet stood against the brick wall one ivy leaf. It was last on the vine, and it was the last leaf left on the vine. Still dark green near its stem. It was still dark green near its stem, but with its edges tinted with yellow. Children, here tinted means slightly. So, but with its edges tinted with yellow. The edges were slightly yellow. It hung bravely from a branch some 20 feet above the ground. So the last ivy leaf was hung bravely from a branch some 20 feet above the ground. It is the last one, said Jonsi. What Jonsi told, that this is the last leaf. I thought it would surely fall during the night. And I thought that it would surely fall during the night. I heard the wind. It will fall today and I shall die at the same time. And I'm sure that it will fall today and I shall die at the same time. Jonsi was preparing herself for the last journey that one makes alone. Jonsi was preparing herself for the last journey means, children, when the person die or when the person go away from this world. Jonsi was preparing herself for the last journey that one makes alone. The feeling was very strong within her and the feeling was very strong within her. The feeling of dying means she thought that as the last leaf will fall, even she too will die or she will go away from this world forever. So now, children, we'll stop here and we'll take a break of 1 minute and we'll continue in the next video. Thank you. Let's continue the lesson. Lesson number 3.3, the last leaf. Children, in the previous video, we have read that how Jonsi was preparing for her last journey that one makes alone. And the feeling was very strong within her. So now let's read further. We were on second paragraph, second last line. The ties of Sue's friendship, ties, the attachment of Sue's friendship and other things on earth become loose one by one. The day wore away, the day passed away, but even through the evening time, or you can say the dusk time, they could see the lone ivy leaf clinging, holding to its stem against the wall. At night again the wind raged, at night again the violent wind blew and the rain poured and the rain falled. Next day when it was light enough, Jonsi asked Sue to open the window. Next morning when it was light enough, Jonsi told Sue to open the window. The ivy leaf was still there. Jonsi laid in her bed for a long time staring at it, staring at the last leaf. Then she called Sue. Sue, dear, she said, I have been a bad girl. I am really a bad girl. Something has made a last leaf stay there to show me how wicked I am. To show me how wicked I was. Wicked, how cruel I was. How cruel I am. It is a sin to want to die. Sin means, children, an immoral act. It is a sin to want to die. After that, she was ready to take the broth and milk that Sue brought her, which Sue had prepared for her. She wanted to sit up in bed. Someday I hope to paint the Bay of Naples. She told that someday I hope to paint the Bay of Naples. Mr. Berman downstairs was now sick with pneumonia. Mr. Berman downstairs was now ill, was sick with pneumonia. The sweeper had found him lying helpless in his room. The sweeper had found him lying helpless in his room in a very wet clothes and shoes. He also found some scattered brushes and palette with green and yellow colors mixed on it. The sweeper had also found some scattered brushes and palette with green and yellow colors mixed on it. 2 days later, Mr. Berman died in a hospital. The last ivy leaf was still there on the wall, and the last ivy leaf was still there on the wall. It never fluttered, it never moved up and down, or moved when the wind blew. It was Berman's masterpiece. It was that leaf which Berman has painted for Jonsi's survival, and it became the masterpiece of Berman. He had painted it there that last night when the last leaf had fallen, which Jonsi used to see through her window. So now, children, the lesson is over, which was adapted from The Last Leaf, written by O. Henry. Now we will stop here, and in the next video we'll discuss the textual question answers. Thank you. Let's continue the lesson. Lesson number 3.3, The Last Leaf. Children, now we will discuss the textual questions. So question number 1 is, read the story and choose the appropriate meanings. The first question is, struggling artists. Options are, artists fighting with one another. Second option is, artists trying hard to earn a living. Third option is, artists painting war scenes. And the correct answer is, artists trying hard to earn a living. Next, question number B, skeleton branches. And the options are, bones branching out from joints. Second, leafy branches. Third, bare branches. And the answer is, bare branches. Next, question number C, wielded the brush. The options are, painted skillfully, broke the brush, joined the broken brush. And the answer is, painted skillfully. Next, question number D, palette. And the options are, the tip of the brush, a board used by artists to mix colors. Next, a fancy dinner plate. And the answer is, a board used by artists to mix colors. Next, question number E, masterpiece. And the options are, a master who promotes peace. Second, the very first creation of an artist. Third, an exceptionally beautiful work of art. And the answer is, an exceptionally beautiful work of art. Next, question number 2. Make pairs of sentences to show the difference between the meanings of the following homographs from the story. The first word is interest, and the sentence is my friend and I share the same interest. Next sentence for the same word, the bank promised high rate of interest to its customers. Next, question number B, the word is well, and the sentence is all the children were well dressed for the party. Next sentence, a big cat fell into the well once. Next, question number C, and the word is left. Sentence is he left for New York an hour ago. Next sentence, my friend can paint beautifully with his left hand. Next, question number D, and the word is just. The sentence is I guess he just wanted to say goodbye. Next sentence, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was a just king. Next, last word is mind, and the sentence is the teacher asked the student to mind their own business. Next sentence, Kiran's mind is always open to new ideas. Now, question number 4. Say whether the following statements are right or wrong. The first sentence is Sue and John C were very close friends, and the answer is right. Next sentence, B. Sue was a rich girl. The answer is wrong. Next, sentence number C. John C was hopeful that she will live, and the answer is wrong. Next, question number D. Berman was a hard-hearted person, and the answer is wrong. Next, question number E. The last leaf fell off during the rain, and the answer is right. Next, sentence number F. John C realized that her thinking was wrong, and the answer is right. Next, sentence number G. Berman did not know anything about the last leaf on the ivy, and the answer is wrong. Now, question number 5 is correct the following statements. The first sentence is Sue and John C were good neighbors, and the answer is Sue and John C were good friends. Next, sentence number B. John C was eager to recover from her illness, and the answer is John C did not show any interest in recovering from her illness. Next, sentence number C. Sue ignored John C completely, and the answer is Sue looked after John C well. Next, sentence number D. Berman was a very heartless person, and the answer is Berman was a very kind-hearted person. Next, sentence number E. The real ivy leaf did not fall off at all, and the answer is the real ivy leaf fell off the night it rained and snowed. Next, sentence number F. The last leaf was a real leaf that survived, and the answer is the last leaf was painted on the wall by Berman. So now children, we have completed the lesson here, and after this video you will get a PDF, copy down all the questions in your question and answer in your notebook. Thank you.